us for our fall jazz ensembles concert. You are in for a treat. We've got three outstanding ensembles for you to hear tonight. First group, the group that's in front of you right now, is the Auburn Junior High School Jazz Ensemble. You will notice it is fairly larger than the average jazz band, and that is for good reason. Starting last year, we now have two jazz bands at the high school, so I have to populate two jazz bands at the high school. And so, come one, come all, just a little bit of background information. Our jazz band meets Monday through Friday at the junior high school at 7 a.m., which is, by the way, the best time in the world for jazz, better than any coffee or soda that you could possibly imagine. And so these students, it's a testament to the work these students are willing to give. Okay, they're willing to show up to school early to practice even more, have more music on their plate. And so we hope you enjoy our concert tonight. We're going to start off with a very well known Duke Ellington tune called "Don't Mean a Thing If You Ain't Got That Swing." And all this kind of stuff. And One of the few things that survived this movie, which was not enormously popular, was a ballad called Somewhere Out There, which was sung by two of the main characters. I would challenge you, we did this in class, please go to YouTube and listen to the original version. Horrible singers. Absolutely horrible. Because they just got the children that played the mice in the movie to sing this song, and neither of them, it's very obvious, neither of them had ever sung professionally before. But it was so adorable that people really, you know, grasped onto it, and it stuck with people. And actually, lots of music, famous music artists during the early 90s actually covered this song and did quite well. So this is Somewhere Out There. Jazzy arrangement of Frosty the Snowman. Here we go.
Thank you.
Before I introduce our next tune and our next guest conductor, I want to make sure that I got to recognize our piano soloist on the beginning of Frosty Snowman, Mr. Jake Evans. We've had a great time this semester, and one of the greatest things about what we've been able to do is that we have had kind of a student teacher work with us this semester, as someone who is no stranger to the Auburn Bands program, and one of my former students who is a senior this year at Auburn High School and is seeking to head to school after Auburn High to pursue a degree in music education. And so he came to me and Ms. Marshall down at Drake Middle School, and we worked out a schedule in which he hangs out with me during 0 o'clock with the jazz band. And he also spends one period a day, every other day, I believe, with Ms. Marshall at Drake Middle School, which, by the way, is the greatest education you could possibly get. I wish I got to hang out with Ms. Marshall when I was in school. So we have really enjoyed having James Birch join us this semester, and so one of the things I told him is that, you know, he's been in our class learning how to be in front of a group and how to rehearse a piece, and so I told him, I said, you can pick whatever song you want as long as it's kind of in our realm of possibilities for the junior high band, and he says, I know exactly what piece I want to do, because it was a piece he played when he was in the 8th grade in the jazz band at Auburn Junior High School, and wanted to kind of pass that along, so seniors that are in here right now that played in the jazz band in 8th grade will know this piece, and so James has been working it up, and the band sounds great. He's done a great job preparing them for this, and so let me introduce our guest conductor for today, Mr. James Birch.
I chose, obviously, it was one of my favorites that I played in junior high jazz band. Wine actually knew of it, but he didn't know actually what it was until he listened to it, because several of the saxophones would play in the lake over and over and over and over and over, and he had no idea where it was from. But now he knows. Now he knows that it's a great piece, so hope you enjoy Larry Barton's Abracadabra.
Thank you.
who's wanting to go into this crazy world of teaching music. But we're thankful that we have students that are heading in that path. We know that all of them will, because we need doctors and other teachers and lawyers, all sorts of wonderful things. But it's good that a couple of them are interested in this. Our last tune for the evening for our set, we'll be back a little bit later on for a special surprise. But our last tune of our set today is one that is no stranger to the Auburn City Schools program. We learn it every single year in jazz band. It's kind of our unofficial fight song for the junior high school. We hope you enjoy and have enjoyed the Auburn Junior High School Jazz Ensemble. This is I'm Tough. Here we go.
Thank you.
helped influence the creation of a lot of different styles and into the rock and everything else. Another area that kind of falls in the jazz realm is Latin music. I try to pick a little bit of several different styles so the students get exposed to them and start to really understand how much music there really is out there, all the different kinds. This next one is a Latin chart. It's called the Jive Samba. However, it's not a samba, so I'm not really sure why he titled it that. It's a cha-cha, but we'll just go with it. This is the Jive Samba.
Thank you. Brian blamed me earlier for him having such a large jazz group down there, but I say it's his fault because he teaches them so well and gets so many kids interested in this that we had to go to two bands up here. So he's really the cause. It's great. We both have the same philosophy on this. We don't want to exclude people from, if they have a passion for learning something new, especially anything to do with music. We hate to not be able to use everybody. And so we make it work up here at the high school with two bands meeting at the exact same time. We do not have a zero period. We are during the normal class day. So this is a normal class that they take out of their 4 to 8, whatever they have, with alternating days. We meet every other day. There's some challenges with how do you rehearse two full-size big bands in the same class period. So we make it work. Hopefully, you know, down the road we'll have some solutions that will help with that. But right now, one of the groups usually rehearses in ensemble. The other group splits into sectionals. So it gives them time to also do some kind of peer mentoring and help within their sections. They get to go off and kind of work as a small unit and learn what it's like to actually rehearse without having somebody standing in front of them teaching everything the entire time. Then we split it and split it next time. The other group will be in sectionals, and we'll see how much we learned in sectionals when we get ensemble again. Next piece we're going to do, we slow down a little bit. This should not be a new song to anybody in here. This is one of Lennon McCartney's great pieces. Obviously, the Beatles, Yesterday, so sit down if you enjoy Yesterday.
Thank you.
next chart is from a movie also. It's a little different than An American Tale, but we like to try to throw in a little rock or funk, and this definitely fits that category. This is the theme from Shaft.
Thank you.
is the Auburn High School Jazz Band A. We're going to start off a tempo swing, Stella by Starlight.
Thank you.
next, Thelonious Monk Shard, featuring, again, you heard Thompson flute just then, there's some other things. Now, Kayla's going to take flute, and you'll hear a little bit of feature on that with Thelonious Monk's Round Midnight.
Thank you.
Ellington's PA train.